family. What? You and me will always be tied. Family every single day and night. Even when you start to acting like a fool, you know I'm loving every single thing you do. I know that I can always be myself. Around you more than anybody else. And every day as I'm heading out to school, you know there's no one I love as much as you. Family.
It's your girl, Tian.
And we are back with another video. But before we get into this video, I already know you read the title, but you clicked on it because what? Your bell was on, and it's Tink and Tiana. So don't forget to do what? Give this video a big old thumbs up. If you're new to the family, make sure you smash that subscribe button to join the gang, 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 gang. Make sure you share the video. Jump down in the comments because your girl, Tiana and Tink like to do what?
Talk back.
And y'all been talking a lot here lately, so we appreciate all of that. We are here for you and the love.
Now, see all y'all comments.
Y'all about to start hearing these same names and these post notification shout outs if y'all don't start commenting down below. It's a lot of y'all in the building. Don't be afraid. We don't bite. We don't bite. So today, because now we can get into it, because y'all read the title, y'all did the thumbs up, all that. We about to debate it. This is something that I wanted to do, like a less debated. And you know what the topic gonna be, right? Exes.
How many of y'all still friends with y'all exes?
That's what we about to talk about, y'all. Is do you think that people can be friends with their exes? Like, this is a hot topic I've been seeing going around Facebook. I've been seeing it on TikTok as well. Instagram, all of that. It's, can you be friends with an ex? Like, what do you think? Is it possible?
It's possible.
Okay.
I feel like it's possible depending on y'all history. I also feel like it's possible depending on the friendship that y'all had. Like, sometimes I feel like a person that's being friends before they get into a serious relationship. So if things don't go well when they end a relationship, they can still remain friends. I mean, sometimes it may not be right away, but eventually I feel like they can become friends.
Okay.
So, I feel like it's possible.
I mean, I know it's possible.
Clearly.
Don't do that. Damn. I know it's possible because I'm friends with a couple of my exes. And I'm friends with a few more on social media. So, I mean, it doesn't really bother me. I think for me, when it comes to an ex, most people are like, oh, they in the past for a reason. Mm-hmm. But that person was there before you. You really don't know what the history is. And sometimes history may outweigh whatever happened. Especially if the ex isn't disrespectful. Because some exes, push my glasses up for that one. Some exes give zero. And they don't believe in karma. Like, my thing is, you should have paid attention when you had the person. Or even when you had me. Don't let me glow up when you see somebody doing the things that you wasn't doing. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's what it is for me. But I don't have an issue with it. If your ex can be respectful and she's respectful of our time, and if she doesn't have the mindset like she'll still be the queen bee, then I don't really have an issue with it. Like, some people are just really sneaky. And I ain't even gonna lie. I was one of them people. I was sneaky about it because most people could not accept that we were strictly platonic friends. So it's easy to say that, oh, this is my best friend. Some people, you can call it lying, you can call whatever you want to. But guess what? Those people that you were dealing with or was dating, they not here no more.
Right.
You not dealing. I'm still here though. So, like, it's a difference for me. I'm like, if we done been through hell and back, you know what I'm saying? And we were friends before anything else, and it was an amicable, we separated, like, we ain't had no beef or nothing. Then, yeah, I'm not going to lie to you about it. I'm going to allow you to make a decision. Mm-hmm. Now, some people may find that, like, kind of deceptive. Eventually, we would say what it really was. You know what I'm saying? But it was never disrespectful. Because then, how you going to try to call me, like, a thot or a hoe, or you still want this person? And I'm like, it's not even given that.
Like, that's now, how long do you feel like, so, because I remember you told me, like, Mm-hmm. Now, how long do you feel like it should take for a person to tell someone that they're still friends with their ex if they're talking to someone? How long do you feel like...
I don't know if I can put a time on that. I say that to say we get so confused. And I know this is probably something that is going to jump off in the comments when it comes to, like, dating somebody or talking to somebody. Is there really a difference? Some people say it's no difference in the talking and
between
dating
talking days. And dating.
Uh-huh.
I feel like there's a difference.
See, I guess I was one of those girls.
I feel like it's a difference that between talking and dating. I feel like talking is more a serious level of dating. I feel like dating is like people are dating other people to just to explore and see who they fuck with.
And see, I'm the opposite.
Really?
But see, then I said I
was talking. Okay, go ahead.
Then I was like, I said I was one of the girls that was probably confused because I feel like if I'm talking to you, it's supposed to be just me. But as I've gotten older, the talking people that I've come into contact with feel like talking. I can talk to you. I can talk to her. I can talk to her, her, and her. And if y'all all know about each other, then you are able to make a decision because I'm not committed to anybody. Dating, I feel like it's a phase when we are starting to get a little more serious. We decided to be exclusive. I don't feel like you have no real rights when you're talking to somebody. But when you're dating somebody, I feel like that's a different level. But that is something that I've learned over the years with those trials that have come my way. tell us in the comments, like, if y'all still rocking with us with this video, give us some feedback. Like, can you be friends with your ex? Oh, this is another one. Since we are talking about exes, what do you do or how do you feel? Say you've been dating somebody for maybe a year or two, and they almost give you an ultimatum when it comes to your exes. Like, do you feel like it's disrespectful to continue a relationship with an ex who has now turned a friend? If your partner has said something to you about it.
So if you talking to this person?
Mm-hmm. And your partner voice is like a concern. Say I said, I have an issue with you still dealing with your ex.
But we have a title as girlfriend.
No, we just dating. Right,
so y'all just dating.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like they don't have that right
to voice how they feel about it, even if y'all are trying to get to know each other.
Because it's like, what if things don't go about? You don't have a title. Like, mm-hmm. Cause it's like me. I don't know. Me personally, I feel like people is always talking to other people regardless,
mm-hmm.
unless they show you otherwise. But I just feel like if I don't have a title with you, how do you have any right to tell me what I can and what I can't do? You didn't give me. We don't have a title yet. So how do you know, or how do I know that you're the one for me? How do you know that we even gonna make it that far? So if I start talking to my ex and then me and you don't work out, then I just stop talking to my ex for what? And we don't even talk no more.
So, is the ex around for security or rebound?
I mean, the ex part could just be around just because she's been around as a friend.
So, do you feel like that would ever block you from getting to know anybody further? Because, you know, I believe in energy and connection.
Yeah, I agree.
So, I'm like, how can we be dating? And I'm trying to express to you how I feel. You want to make me, like, your new woman. But at the same time, you giving me, like, pushback because you still got your bestie ex in your corner. Y'all have time and y'all had a connection.
So you would feel like their ex is there as a rebound.
And I would feel like you're not taking me seriously. I'm just telling you how I feel.
Then at that point, you would just have the choice.
I don't know about everybody, but I've been in some situations where that don't worry about it person ended up being somebody I needed to worry about. I'm just saying, like, everybody is different.
Yeah.
And you know what I'm saying? Like, y'all can always talk about some of y'all little stuff in the comments, too. Like, girl, if y'all want us to debate another topic, drop that down in the comments. Because this is what we like doing. Like, we don't agree on everything all the time. But me and Tink had to get to a point where we had to, one, talk to each other, understand where we were coming from, understand each other's traumas, and then decide if we wanted to pick up the ball and go anywhere from there. Like, we had to get to a point where we could talk to it. We're still working on it, you know what I'm saying, with certain things, but we could talk to each other about everything. And for me, in a relationship, it's about the respect. So that's why we said that.
And it took a while for me to do that.
Yeah,
I don't know how she did it, y'all, but I definitely salute her.
I'm a survivor. All right, sorry.
It was help. My trust was just all fucked up. I mean, I ain't gonna really get into it, but I salute you.
I'm still here, you know. Right. But that's how it is when it comes to exes. I mean, it could be a very touchy, sensitive subject, but I feel like you got to be able to trust the person that you're with. Like, you're the one that I got to deal with. Because that's why I never really understand why they always want to fight the girl sometimes. It takes two to tango.
Right.
It takes two. But
I would never get into it with the other person unless that person attacks me or say something to me. Because you're not my bitch. You're not who I'm dating. You're not who I'm having in the bed with. So I'm not about to sit here and have an argument with you. They should have known better. So I'm going to talk to them about it.
I agree. We can't wait to see what y'all going to talk about in the comments, what y'all got to say, because, you know, we really want to make this an interactive thing, and this is probably something we can begin to do on live as well, but we want to keep bringing y'all content.
Yeah, even if y'all want to see, like, if y'all have a topic that y'all want us to talk about, drop it down, we're going to talk about it. We like doing this kind of stuff.
Absolutely. Because, you know, exes can be a tricky thing.
Mm-hmm.
A tricky thing. A tricky. I don't know how many tricks are for kids. Tricky. But, you know, y'all, we hope y'all enjoyed this video, because I definitely did. Like, this was a good one.
Mm-hmm.
We can always get in depth more when it comes to relationship topics. If y'all have any other questions for us too in the topics, jump down in the comments and tell us. Because we know, say, your past is your past for a reason. Sometimes, you know, people come into your life as a blessing or a lesson. And sometimes they can actually be both. But know your worth. If you know you got something good in front of you, don't keep looking backwards, because all you're going to do is fall. Just saying.
Facts.
TNT game. Oh, no. I'm about to mess up again, y'all. We ain't about to run away. I did my homework.
Now I'm slipping.
Now she's slipping, y'all. I was on it.
It was the Reese cut, y'all.
It was. And she ain't offered me not a one. Did y'all see
ain't
her?
Ain't nothing in my mouth, and I'm still smacking.
Do y'all know what time it is? Y'all know. They got a finger. She made it.
I told you, that finger's strong. That's a strong game. Drop down in the comments, finger game. Drop down in the comments, y'all. Finger gang.
Don't.
Finger strong.
Don't.
Strong finger.
Don't. Let me give it to you one more time.
Please don't. Drop that, y'all. Finger gang.
Don't. I'm going to keep saying don't. Hey, no, don't do that, y'all. Anyway, it's time for the post notification shout
out. Oh, man.
So this week's post notification. Hey, I still don't want to tell y'all what it is because I can't get it out clearly. Hey, yo. Yo, this week's post notification shout out goes to AK Robertson. What's up, family? What up? Gang, 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 gang.
Gang, gang.
Camille Harris, welcome to the family. Welcome to the tribe.
Gang, gang. Welcome, welcome,
and
welcome.
And Tia Ward, I see you. Thank you so much. I appreciate welcome. The love.
Gang, gang. All day.
So if y'all want to hear y'all name at the end of every video, make sure y'all do what? Like these videos. Share these videos. Subscribe to the TNT family. Don't forget to jump down in those comments. Tell us what y'all want to see. Tell us what y'all want us to do. Within reason, we will make sure we get them done. And until next time, TNT gang, we out this thing. Gang,
gang. Beep, beep, beep,
beep, beep, beep, beep, beep. Throw that ass in the circle. Throw that ass in the circle. Ooh, throw that ass in the circle. Yeah. Oh, shit now. 'Did you press start? It's your girl Tiana.
It's your girl Tink.
And we are back. Why was my eyes closed? No, that's not gonna work. I was like this, Tiana Ghetto. Oh my god. Let's try that again. And my jaws are so tight from laughing.
I just wanna pick up this Reese's. All right. Bullshit.
What's up? Corvette. Anyway, okay. How you want to play that?
I thought you were doing it.
I don't really know it. Try it again.
Are you walking like that?
I got that part.
Are you walking like that?
Anyway, what's up, YouTube? It's your girl Tiana.
It's your girl Tink.
And my eyes were closed again. Give up on trying to do this intro. We just about to start this video, y'all.